Today in the Indian Ocean, the search continued for the missing Malaysian Airlines flight.
It's hard to believe, but it's been almost a month now since that plane disappeared. And as we first told you yesterday, the missing plane prompted an international group to call for some major changes.
And Jeff joins us now with what kind of change it is they're looking for. We're all ears, Jeff.
Well, it's with technology and security. People within the industry still can't believe that an airliner would go missing. And then they were also amazed that people with stolen passports were able to make it on board. So those are two major changes that they are looking at. Now, most countries, including Malaysia, do not run passports through Interpol. And on that flight, two men with stolen passports made it on the plane. Authorities don't believe they were terrorists. That has pretty much been ruled out. They were thinking they're just migrants trying to get to Europe. However, the fact that they made it on board shows that the system needs improvements. And as far as tracking aircraft, aviation officials say it is inconceivable that with today's technology, an aircraft could just go missing like this. The U.S. is currently utilizing its best technology to try to help find that missing plane, but as Secretary of Defense Chuck Hagel points out, even our pinger locators can only do so much.
This very sophisticated equipment that we have provided, and we have provided, as far as I know, everything the Malaysian government has requested of us, is really reliant totally on defined search areas.
So we hear a lot about the transponder when it comes to finding aircraft. Well, the transponder may not be needed at all because of some new tech known as triggered transmission. It's a system that acts as its own server on board. And the way it works is anytime the airplane banks or dives too steeply or goes too fast or too slow, it automatically sends out a burst of data that gives its position information. And with that Malaysian flight, that would have really come in handy. The issue with that is it costs $50,000 to put that technology in each aircraft, and you multiply that by hundreds of planes, and that means tens of millions of dollars. Now, the bigger airlines can afford that bill. The smaller airlines, though, it would put them out of business.
Well, you would almost understand a little more if this happened frequently, and then you gotta wonder if there's other technology that's cheaper that could have prevented this.
Yeah, and you also have to factor in how much money has been spent in this search alone over the past few weeks.
Right,
you know,
it's unbelievable.
Against what the cost is to equip these planes, you know.
A lot to consider. Thanks, Jeff. Yeah.